In the old days, all you needed was a beer carton and a bit of candle, but these days you can use a professional sandboard. I'm so excited. Don't scream when you're sand tobogganing, or you'll just eat sand. Can't even see either.
Get the latest beach conditions with Liz Cantor every Friday and Saturday night. Make the switch to 7 News at 6.
Good news for the beachgoers, with today's cloud coverage expected to clear and sunshine predicted for Saturday and Sunday. Here at Noosa Main Beach, I found sisters Shauna and Hannah, who I had to give a big thumbs up to for their sun safety.
Well, the holidays are here, so bear in mind that regular flagged areas will be crowded, but they're still the safest place to be for swimmers. Tomorrow, light east-northeast winds are due, and the pick of the spots for families will be Kings Beach, Caloundra and the northern Gold Coast beaches. Also, keep a heads up for blue bottles. They're really common with these onshore winds. For the surfers, keep your fingers crossed that the morning winds will remain light, and then the best bet will be the open beaches. Try Yurumba to Makula on the Sunshine Coast and the Spit and Diba on the Goldie. So don't forget, you can grab any last minute information you need on surfing, diving and fishing on the web at coastwatch.com.au.
Well, with this afternoon's low tide and the late sunset, I'd recommend grabbing a tennis ball and cricket bat and making the most of the firm sand. Nothing like a round of summer beach cricket. What do you reckon, girls?
Yeah!
Well, have a good one and I'll see you tomorrow night.
And don't forget, the latest update on conditions can be found on the net at coastwatch.com.au.
Here at Snapper, it's becoming very popular for surfers to jump off the rocks to save time from paddling out. It should really only be done by locals or very experienced surfers. Yesterday, I saw two people get washed off the rocks. It's really dangerous if you're not familiar with the conditions. I'll be back tomorrow with the latest on Sunday. See you then. A southerly change pushed up the coast last night, bringing with it showers. By this morning, they had tapered off. However, the fresh onshore winds continued to conjure up thick coastal cloud. Overnight, rainfall totals across the southeast were 10 to 30 millimetres at most. Currently in the city, it's 25 degrees. On tonight's chart, thundery showers will continue over the tropics under the monsoonal trough, which has actually weakened since last week, creating a slightly more stable atmosphere. This high pressure system is responsible for our cooler weather, so at this stage, we'll have to factor in a shower or two for any Australia Day plans.
Not ideal for a barbecue outside, but I'm sure we'll still find a way to celebrate. Thanks, Liz.
Liz Cantor with the latest beach reports every Friday and Saturday night.
It's a tough job. Someone's got to do it.
7 News at 6.